How's the royal family? I pray that everyone is doing well. Well, my royal family, I got a good one for you today. Well, let me read the title of this article. Trump administration will protect healthcare workers who refuse services on religious grounds. Okay. Healthcare workers who want to refuse to treat patients because of religious or moral beliefs will have a new defender in the Trump administration. The top civil rights officials at the Department of Health and Human Services is creating a division of conscious and religious freedom to protect doctors, nurses, and other healthcare workers who refuse to take part in procedures like abortions or treat certain people because of moral or religious objections. Let's see here. And it says here that the establishment of the division reverses an Obama-era policy that bar health care workers from refusing to treat transgender individuals or people who have had or seeking abortions. Oh my goodness. Now the plot thickens. So my royal family, I have two short videos to play for the royal family. So I'm going to play this one first. And it's short. So I'm going to have to stop in between it because it goes into some other stuff. But this is very important for the royal family to hear. So let's see here.
Administration announced Thursday a plan to protect health workers who morally or religiously object to performing abortions or other treatments. The U.S. Department of Health and Human Services will create a new division within its Office of Civil Rights that will enforce the rights of religious freedom. Reuters correspondent Caroline Humer.
So this division is going to do the sort of enforcement work around this. So if a healthcare worker comes forward and makes a complaint, then this division will look at it and decide whether or not this complaint will be upheld. And experts think that this will be basically the division's responsibility to kind of push back the lines in terms of what exemptions workers and hospitals can, you know, practice when it comes to these kinds of services.
The new division is likely to face legal and ethical challenges. The American Civil Liberties Union says religious freedom is not a license to discriminate. According to reports, transgender patients could fall under this new shield for health workers as well. Democrats were quick to criticize the move.
Democrats don't like this. And Senator Patty Murray this morning sent out a statement just saying like that this was something that was probably going to deprive rights of people, of women, of transgender people, that left discrimination open.
The decision by the Trump administration comes just a day before the annual March for Life in Washington, D.C., where anti-abortion activists and supporters march the Capitol streets.
Let me shut that down quickly, my royal family, and let's slide over here.
Just stirred some serious medical controversy.
The Health and Human Services Department created a new division called the Conscience and Religious Freedom Division. It's going to be dedicated to protecting the rights of healthcare workers who have either moral or religious objections to performing abortions, providing health services to people who identify as transgender or for whatever reason, you know, based on a religious or moral issue, object to providing certain medical services.
The controversial move will see two groups getting hit the hardest, women in need of abortions and people who identify as LGBTQ. Here's what Dr. Jen Canty, an OBGYN and fellow with Physicians for Reproductive Health, had to say about the new legislation.
As a physician, you know, I've taken an oath to protect people. All healthcare providers have taken an oath to protect whoever walks in the door, no matter what. It's a really slippery slope. And I think that you're opening the door to potentially really dangerous situations where people don't get the healthcare that they need.
And with 29% of transgender people saying they've already had a doctor refuse to see them because of their gender identity, this new civil rights division is likely to embolden even more doctors to refuse treatment to the LGBTQ community.
People will keep themselves out of care. They won't go seek needed medical care. They won't go seek preventative care. So there's going to be consequences to people's health and well-being. There are going to be consequences to our healthcare system at large.
Since President Trump took office, they've taken steps to staff HHS with people that have a track record of opposing contraceptive programs, opposing abortion rights, and also endorsing protections for people who, for religious reasons, want to deny either services or care to people because they fall into certain classes, either because they are seeking an abortion or because they're gay, lesbian, or transgender.
Take Richard Severino. He's the head of HHS's Civil Rights Office, and he has a long history of advocating on behalf of religious groups and opposing gender transition services.
As some of you know, my background is in civil rights. I came from religious liberty coming out of law school. I was at the Department of Justice Civil Rights Division for 7 years. And I did notice that our first freedom, as enshrined in the Constitution, didn't always get the attention and protection that it was due.
We don't know what any new rules or regulations look like just yet, but they've established an office that is supposed to, as they describe it, protect people's rights to deny service based on their conscience, and based on the administration's already declared stance on religious liberty. Yet again, it looks like there could be some pretty big legal battles ahead for healthcare.
All right, my royal family. All right, now, I'm gonna keep it core with the royal family. I already know that ultimately, in the end, this is going to greatly impact the royal family, because what Trump's KKK cabinet has just said is that you can outwardly discriminate against anyone that you feel some kind of way about when you up in your feelings in your profession in the healthcare field. Now, they're going to always start with, the abortion and the transgender, but there is no way that you cannot leave out us. It's like we don't even exist. And so they're going to ask you, well, what is your religion? We in the royal family, we got people that are Christians, Jehovah Witness, Muslims, Hebrew Israelites, and I can go on and on and on and on. So that particular healthcare worker may feel some kind of way because of what you practice too as well. They may be totally against what you practice. So he just left the door wide open to openly discriminate based on anything. Now, I can understand people may have their feelings about abortions, and I can understand people may have their feelings about people's preference as far as they are transgender or they are homosexual or whatever. I have my particular feelings about it. But on a human level, when you are practicing unquote medicine and a human being is literally dying before your eyes, basically what they are saying, based on your religious views, you have a right to practice whatever you practice, whatever your choice is, that shields you and that protects you so that person can drop fucking dead. But ultimately, in the end, it always lands on our feet. It really do. Because I'm just going to keep it core. In the gay community, they have an economical base. They have lawyers that will fight fiercely for them. They have full protection. The royal family have no economical base at all. They don't have a team of lawyers that can protect their human rights. That's what it all boils down to. Now, maybe I'm looking at it the wrong way, my royal family, and I know it's some people that sub to this channel that work in the healthcare field. If I am off basis and I stand to be corrected, please correct me. But I'm just looking at it the way that I'm looking at it. Just left the door wide open to discriminate, and then it's going to start going into other industries. This is all this is about when they say they want to make America great again. Eventually, they will have their way. We'll be going back to separate toilets. We'll be going back to separate drinking fountains and everything. Now, I'm all for separation, 100%. Oh, yes, I am. But we are so incorporated in this system, it's going to take literally a lifetime to separate. And then we got some of our own that are so in love with these people, they don't want to separate at all. Wow. These are truly, truly the last days. Now, this also gives folks a white flag at also saying, hey, openly discriminate. However you feel about whatever, you can openly do it. We're going to have you, some type of protection for you. Trust and believe, this will spill over in many genres. So, my royal family, do what you do best. Render your voice with your beautiful, divine words. Let's mix it up. It's safe to mix it up here. I want to hear what people really think about this. I'm concerned about this one. So anyway, my royal family, I thank you for your love. I thank you for your support. And with that said, ashe.